Hello there, my name is Cody and I'm with LaunchDarkly, and in this video, we're going to explore our React SDK and show how we can get LaunchDarkly up and running in a React application really quickly. If you take a look at the screen we have up right now, you can see all of the different languages that we support. We have a number of different client or server-side SDKs that are supported. In this video, as I mentioned, we're going to be exploring React, but we also support React Native as well as JavaScript if we're looking for something more specific. Our documentation has all the steps outlined on how to get the React SDK installed and up and running in your environment. You'll definitely want to bookmark and use this page when you're getting started, as all of the commands and different imports are set up right in there for you to bring into your project. For us, we're going to jump right into some live code and see how we can get this running. When we switch into our application directory and click on our app.js file, we can see that this is a really basic React application. It was scaffolded using Create React App, and I made a couple of changes to bring in the LaunchDarkly components. I already ran my npm install of the LaunchDarkly client SDK, which you can find in our documentation, and I've started to bring in the configurations that support LaunchDarkly. Namely, I've wrapped my app component in this withld provider component. Inside of this, I've brought in my client-side ID. You can get that from inside of the LaunchDarkly portal by hitting Command or Control K and selecting the copy SDK key and client-side ID. Otherwise, you can go into the account settings and get it there. This is how we allow the React application to communicate back to LaunchDarkly and pull down flag values. As part of that setup, we've also imported in the withld provider as well as use flags from the LaunchDarkly React client SDK. We've defined out a couple of variables around the use flags function. New header and logo version are both flags that live within LaunchDarkly. We can see a couple of conditional renders down here where we're saying if new header is true, load the header component that we've created, and then also to return different logos based on the flag values. If we switch into LaunchDarkly, we can see our two flags set up there, new header and logo version. If we take a look at our application, we just see the React symbol spinning in the middle of the screen. Now at our most basic level, we can turn on these two flags, save our changes for each one, and take a look at how our application has changed. We can see we now have a spinning logo in the middle of the screen, and we have a welcome to LaunchDarkly and React text on the top as well. Now, one of the most powerful capabilities of LaunchDarkly is how we can use identity to drive the different flag values that are returned back to a user. What this means is that we can start to show different components of a web page based on the user that LaunchDarkly is identifying. In order for us to do this, we need a logon box, obviously. Let's go ahead and implement that now. We're going to go ahead and jump into LaunchDarkly, and since we're adding a new feature, we're going to create a new flag, and we're going to call it login box. It's going to be true or false. We'll name it box on versus box off. This targeting is off for now. We're going to switch back into our code and implement that flag now. Where we define out the variables that are attached to use flags, we'll go ahead and add that flag in. We'll call it login box. And then down here below our logo, we'll create an operation that'll let us make the conditional render similar to what we've used before. What this says is if login box is true, we'll render our login component that we've created, which is located up here in our components folder. Otherwise, we'll render a blank div out. So we'll save this, switch back into our application to verify it's not there. Go ahead and turn on the flag now to test out our new feature. And we can see that flag is now enabled and showing a logon box below. With this logon box in place, we can start to do logins and actually render user data back to LaunchDarkly. So now we're going to change the animation that's playing here for the spinning logo. If we switch back into our application code and take a look at our CSS, we see we have two different animations. We have an app logo and an animation that does a simple spin. And then we have an app pulse that does a pulse view. We'll jump back into LaunchDarkly, and we're going to create a flag called animate. We'll name this one animate. And instead of a Boolean, we'll do a string, and we're going to push down some values. For value one, when it's on, we'll do app pulse. And variation two will be the existing spin. Now, by default, we're going to turn this to only show spin so that nobody ever sees it unless they're explicitly part of our user group. We'll do pulse for Cody, turn on targeting, and save our changes. Now we'll switch back into LaunchDarkly or into our application and make our code changes. We'll bring in our animate flag, and then within our actual image text, we'll change this class name to be a variable instead. Our animate variable, and we'll do this for both versions, and save our changes. Now, when we switch back into the application, we see nothing has changed. If I was to log in with someone like test, nothing changes. But if I type in Cody and hit enter, we're getting our new animation, the pulsing logo. I hope this video was helpful at showing you how it's really easy to create new features and roll them out using React. We were able to play with user identity and show how doing targeting will allow us to change aspects of our application based on users that are coming in. We're really excited to hear the different ways that you're using React in your environment. Please reach out to us. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks a lot.